Hi, for Form Butler, we need to send out an email with that has the form URL, so a customer can click on the email, can click on the URL in the email and just go to the Form Butler webpage, so they can fill in their documents. For this email, we are using an email.config. If you want to read more on learn more on email.config, you can go to our academy, and everything is explained right here. The basics are that instead of using an email that's in a classic email template in Salesforce, we actually start from a Word document. With these emails, you have far more capabilities when managing data and putting data in there. That's why in this case, we select for an email.config. Now, as you can see in this email, it's very basic, very simple, but I want the first name, I want the owner name, and of course, I want my form URL. First, let's start with the easy bits. That's these two. This information comes from our opportunity. So I'm just going to change the opportunity. Data source to add these fields. Okay, just going to add here the primary contact. So that's our contact relation, and I'm going to go here for the first name. Okay, just this field. Now I'm going to go back. And next up is the owner. I'm going to go for the owner, follow the relation, and I'm going to go for the full name for this one. Okay, so that's it. Now these two fields have been added. And okay, cool. Let's save this query. That one is done. Now, next up, we're going to create a new data source. And this new data source is actually going to select data from the Form Butler request object. So every time you send out a request for somebody to fill in their documents, we are going to create a record called a Form Butler request. This record will have the URL that we need to be sent in the email. So we're going to create a data source that will actually just get the URL from that record. Okay, this is going to be called Form Butler as always, and then it's request. It's a single object because we're going to create one request, of course, and then that's that. So let's go to the SQL Builder, go here, and we call this form. So Form Butler request is right here. So I'm going to select this object. Now, what information do I need? I need information, of course, on the opportunity. That field is not there yet. Then I need the URL. Okay, I need the URL, and I need the, let's go for the record ID as well. Okay, sounds good. Now we're going to add some filters. Gonna go on the record ID equals record ID, add this one, and then save my query. Now, a little trick here, you're going to have to update this this data source, and you're going to change the record ID into a parameter called form ID. Okay, so that's not a problem, because now we can actually just use an extra parameter. So we have our record ID, that's our opportunity, and we have our form ID, that's actually the record in Form Butler, our Form Butler request. Okay, let's save, and now we have the data sources we need for Form Butler to manage everything.